Oke, good morning.
Morning, sir. Good morning.
Okay, so before we start our class today, I would like to discuss your idea for system that your group will develop. Okay. Let's start with Evangeline and Livia, Amelia Kristanto. Here you say that you want to build a sales for a stationery store. Can you explain a little bit about your idea here? Angeline, Lydia?
Yes.
Okay, can you explain what do you mean by sales for stationery store?
So I want to make like
maybe Evangeline could help.
So we will make an application that sells the stationery.
With sales, what do you mean? Do you record sales or do you handle the whole revenue cycle process?
We record sales.
Record. Okay. What kind of sales? Is it credit sales or cash?
Cash. Cash.
Cash, okay. Is it in-store sales or online sales?
We think about in-store sales.
Okay. So your application will be a desktop application, like you have to install it on laptop or PC, or is it should be installed in mobile devices like smartphone or tablet?
We can laptop.
Okay, laptop. Okay, so is it installed in laptop or did you use cloud to store the data? Look, if you don't have the answer right now, that's fine. I mean, this is some things that you need to think for the next few days for your system, because eventually all of the groups need to write down the description of what their intended system. Okay, I think that's fine. I get the big picture, but later on, Livia and Evangeline, you need to describe the system that you want to build clearly. You can start after this lecture to write down what do you mean by sales for stationery store. Okay, thank you. Stefan Kenji and Landrikus Revit. Okay, Stephen Kenzie and Andrikus Trevin. You said here that you want to build inventory management system for fast food restaurant. What kind of fast food restaurant?
I think we are going to make an application about inventory, but fried chicken restaurant.
Okay.
So we are going to record every goods that is in and out every day.
Okay.
And it is automatically. So if, for example, we use 50 piece of chicken in a day, it will automatically reduce our stock. And
okay.
Also it will calculate our COGS, cost of goods sold, to help the accountant. It's going to help them to make the financial statement as well.
Okay, well, it's impossible to create financial statement just by using inventory record. That's for one. Second, you need to understand how a fast food restaurant works. In any fast food restaurant, as far as I know, the standard practice is they have a big storage, huge storage, that set that the temperature was set under 0 degrees Celsius. That's for main storage for all their perishable ingredients, chicken, cheese, probably vegetables and any other like flour, things like that. And then they will, before the production, before they cook the ingredients, they move or pick up the inventory from the main storage to the floor or store storage. There are standards, health standards, that for example, if a cheese has been in a refrigerator in the store floor, shop floor, before cooking, it only be kept for few hours. After that, it has to be discarded. Now, I've been to McDonald's and I see how they work. There are buckets of discarded ingredients, cheese, vegetables, bun, beef patty, chicken, fried chicken that has been fried, but until certain hours, they could not sell it, so they discarded. Your inventory need to record this kind of process. Okay, and similar to my question to Evangeline and Olivia, will it be a mobile or desktop? Will you use local storage or cloud system? You need to think about it. One more thing, what kind of inventory management you want to use? Is it FIFO, LIFO, or do you use perpetual or physical inventory record? Kenji, Andrews.
Okay, maybe we want to make.
No. Don't use maybe. You have to definitely sure that you want.
Okay.
There is no maybe.
We want to make a FIFO system, first in, first out, yeah. And after that for the recording system, we make a perpetual.
Okay.
Like that.
Okay. So you need to understand, like I said, the business process inside that, and also the will your system provide reminder for the store manager if they need to replenish the supplies. Like for example, you only have cheese for another 2 days, then you have to buy new cheese, or you only have chicken for another. I mean, inventory system is simple, but the information that produced by this system should help the manager to manage the inventory, because you said it in your writing, inventory management system. So the system should produce report, like for example, to forecast inventory requirements, to forecast how many inventory should the manager buy in the next few weeks, for example. That's inventory management. Not just recording the product in and out, but also to create information for forecasting. That's inventory management. Otherwise, it's useless, okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Now, Giovan, Dwi Natal, and Maria Ignacia. You said it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Payroll on service company. What kind of service company?
We think maybe take the transportation service company.
What? Can you repeat it?
Transportation service
okay,
company.
Transportation. Okay, so you will deal with the driver?
Yes, the driver.
Okay. Now, with service company, with transportation companies, you need to understand the basis for the driver to be paid. Is it hourly basis or do you have any other formula to calculate the payroll? Okay, that first. Yeah, because will it be based on the working hours or will it be based on the kilometers they run? What kind of transportation? This is a taxi or a bus or rental car or what?
Maybe
specific. No, maybe you have to be specific.
Okay.
You have to be specific because like, bus are different from taxi, for example.
Like a motorcycle or maybe like motorcycle, I think. We think
motorcycle? What do you mean? Like object? Okay, so what's the basis for payroll calculation? Kilometers or
kilometers.
Hour? Kilometers. Okay. Now, with payroll, you need to understand that there is a minimum wage requirement. What happened if a driver, motorcycle driver, did not have enough kilometers to be paid based on minimum wage? So for example, the minimum wage say 1 million, that driver only accumulate 800,000. So what happened? Because so, if you do not pay that driver using minimum wage, you will be punished by the government.
Okay.
That's in violation of the law.
Yes.
Okay. Will you pay for the fringe benefit, BPJS Ketenagakerjaan, BPJS Kesehatan? It has to be. You need to calculate that. Any insurance, any other insurance? Do you include fuel or do the driver have to pay for the fuel? How about the who own the motorcycle, your company or the driver?
Okay.
If you haven't thought about it, that's fine. I suspect that you think about a company like Gojek, right?
Yes, sir. Like
Gojek. Well, okay. You have to understand the process in Gojek, but you can that it's quite different. Okay, but you need to understand and create the system accordingly. Okay, but you need to think about minimum wage, who pay for fuel, who pay for maintenance, insurance like BPJS, tenaga kerjaan and BPJS kesehatan, and any other things that need to be calculated. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
And last but not least, Joshua Leonard and Arya Dwiardana.
Yes, sir. So our idea is
customer record in transportation business. Okay, what kind of transportation again? Like Giovan and Maria.
Similar to Gio and Maria, we use online transportation in specifically in town, in rural area where the user is use the application or use the
service. Is it motorcycle or car or bus or trucks?
It focus on motorcycle and car like taxi, so we can.
What do you mean by customer record?
So like we store the customer data like their address, their usual traffic, how far they travel in within a day, and what kind of type of vehicle they use. So when they log into their profile, and when they use our service, we can see what kind of vehicle they using, how far they use, and we can use our customer data to forecast, or we can sell the data to other companies.
Okay, I'm curious about how would you calculate the type of vehicles or the length of traveling.
So the type of vehicle is only two, like only car or motorcycle.
Okay, and so if I, for example, if I in a week I use 5 cars and 5 motorcycles. So which one that I like the most? See, that's just difficult. Now, if you haven't think about it, you need to think about it. Now, similar to kilometers, will you just simple average, which is misleading, or do you use any other statistical tools? You have to think about it. Okay. Okay. Good. Thank you all. I guess I need to. I got all the information that I required from you. However, you need to write down. If you haven't think about the question that I asked today, please write down in more details and more complete description of your proposed system. Okay, so it will be required as one of the assignment, not next week, but soon. So you need to start to prepare for it. Okay. Sorry. Now, for the next assignment, this is due in 1 week, so next week before the start of our lecture. In this class, you propose to make the system. So you build the system, you develop the system, but you know very well that outside in the marketplace, in an app store or any other place, a lot of people would have built and sold similar system to the one that you propose. Okay. So in this part, you need to justify why you need to build the system instead of buy. From business perspective, the decision to make or buy boil down to one factor, which is whichever is cheaper. So business or any companies will opt for the cheaper option. If it's cheaper to make, then they will make it. If it's cheaper to buy, then they will buy it. Okay. However, the cost of building or buying a software is a bit complicated. Okay, I will explain that to you on today's lecture. Okay, so basically, you need to justify why your proposed system should be developed rather than bought. Okay, so the company will need to develop the system instead of buying the system. That's your assignment for next week. Any question about the assignment? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, for today's lecture. So the sources of software, this is where we discuss where you can get the system that you need. So there are various sources of software for organization, and obviously each sources has different criteria to evaluate, but it's boiled down to cost. Okay, whichever cost less will be selected. However, the cost composition and also what constitute as cost would be different. We cannot justify our decision to make or buy just by using purchase price or acquisition cost. Okay. We need to think about the future cost, the operational cost, the maintenance cost, and things like that. Okay. We will discuss that further. So, the first option for basically software, if you need software or system, there are three options. Well, two basic options, make or buy. Okay. If you want to make, it can be done by your organization, yourself, or asking somebody else to build the system for you if you don't have the expertise. And that's the outsourcing. Okay, outsourcing means that you ask somebody to build the system for you, and that somebody is a company or consultants outside your company. Okay, so it's turning over responsibility of information system application to outside firm. Outsourcing has been done for very long time, more than 40 years. It started when Kodak was the biggest film manufacturing company in the 70s. One day Kodak decided to outsource their IT function to IBM. So what Kodak did, they sold all their IT asset, their computers, their servers, their printers, even their IT department with all the employees were sold to IBM. So the Kodak's IT staff become IBM's employee. So what happened then? IBM was responsible to provide IT function. If Kodak need computer, IBM will provide it. If Kodak needs programmer, IBM will provide it. Okay. What Kodak did, just pay IBM. I need 10 computers, they pay for 10 computers. I need a software to be made, they pay IBM to create the software, things like that. That's outsourcing. Okay. A company that runs parallel application for client. There are many outsourcing examples. Even our university, we use outsourcing. Microsoft Team, for example. We don't build Microsoft Team ourselves. We just ask Microsoft to provide us with Microsoft Teams, with email. Okay. That's why this semester we use two tools for distance learning or online learning. Actually, the Situs Kuliah, they already have this kind of facilities for conferencing, for chatting, things, but as you may remember, Situs Kuliah often had difficulties to cope with high usage. Microsoft, on the other hand, they have the second largest facility in the world for this kind of works. Okay, we will discuss it later. The first company, the biggest company that rival Microsoft is Amazon. Okay, so why outsource? Cost effective. This is the highest reason, the top reason for outsourcing. Cost effective. Why? Because many companies are not IT companies. They don't have enough resources for managing their IT function. So why don't we give that to somebody else that have expertise in IT management? Take advantage of economies of scale. Imagine this. How much is cost to buy Microsoft Office? Probably about around 1 to 2 million. If I give you 10 million, can you build Microsoft Office? I don't think so. Okay, but Microsoft, they can build Microsoft Office and they can sell it at lower cost. Okay, why? That's economies of scale, because Microsoft has millions and millions of customers. Okay, free up internal resources, because IT is not our main business, then we can free up the IT department and focus on the core business. Reduce time to market, because we don't need to build anything for IT, increase process efficiency, and it's like I said, this is non-core activity for most organizations. For Google, for Facebook, Microsoft, building a system is their core activity. That's what they sell. But for Kodak, their core activity is to produce film, celluloid film, not movie film. Now, where we can get the software? We can buy or asking IT service firm to build the system. We can buy package software like Microsoft Office, SPSS, and any other package. Okay, we can use enterprise-wide solutions, application service provider. We will discuss this. Open source software and in-house developer. We build them ourselves. Yeah. So this is the source of software. Now, outsourcing IT service firm. This is the one that I mentioned earlier. If we don't have sufficient internal resources, we can ask somebody else that has expertise in developing system to develop, host, and run application for customer. So we just pay them, and we use the product. Package software producer. If you look at your mobile phone or your tablet and open the application store, you can find thousand and thousand of application. Anything that you need, starting from recording your voice to record your diary, phone books, or even telling you the fortune or telling you the weather today, that they have app for it. Okay. And it's run on anything, start from mobile phone to the supercomputer. Okay. And it's called sometimes it's called commercial off the shelf or COTS. The problem with this prepackaged software is you could not customize it. Okay. If say for example you find a software that can be used for video editing and you love that software, unfortunately it's only run on Apple Macintosh and you don't have Apple Macintosh, bad luck. You could not change that software to run on Windows. Technically it's possible, but legally no. Every time you install a software, you need to see the end user's license agreement, and most commercial prepackaged software, they have a clause that prohibit user to modify the software. Okay, for example, if you want to change software that run on my Macintosh to be able to run on Windows, that's prohibited. Okay, and if they don't have a Windows version, bad luck, or things like that. Okay. Most of the time, off-the-shelf software meet 70% of organization needs. Okay, and a lot of our needs can be fulfilled with this kind of software. You want operating system? Instead of building yourself, you can just grab Windows or Macintosh. You need some software to write a document? Grab Microsoft Word. If you need software to for presentation, just PowerPoint or any other software. Okay. These are the company that sell package software. This is old data, but a lot of these companies still exist today. IBM, Microsoft, EDS, Accenture, HP, Oracle, SAP, Capgemini, Lockheed Martin. Some of them sell specialized software. For example, Lockheed Martin usually sell software for defense or military application. So you cannot buy Lockheed Martin software. Oracles and SAP, they are mainly focused on business software. HP, I know for a fact that the Australian Tax Office use HP software. Okay. This is Microsoft Project, one of the prepackaged software. You just buy, install it, and use it. That's it. Okay. Enterprise solution software. This is like SAP. If I can see that. So this is SAP. Okay. This is the most popular enterprise software. This is a software to manage the whole enterprise, starting from payrolls, combined with sales, integrated with research and development, things like that. Okay. So that's the price. resource planning. Our government, the Ministry of Finance, they use Oracle software for Oracle Business Suite, if I'm not mistaken, to manage the budget. So our APBN was managed using Oracle Business Suite. Okay, so this is the Oracle. You already have this from your MIS course. Okay, what interpretation? Cloud computing. This is a special kind of outsourcing, where instead of you install the software in your laptop or desktop and store the data inside your company or inside your organization, we use cloud. So all the computing resources, application, storage, and everything are done over the internet, just like Microsoft Teams, just like our email, just like things. So we use this to host our application and also storage. It's a lot cheaper for company and a lot easier for company to use cloud computing. When I was the head of computer labs in 2007, I've been dealing with installing and setting up 200 PCs, and it require 3 days of overtime works to prepare them. But using cloud computing, that's easy. Take Facebook, for example. Facebook is one of the cloud computing application, although it's not really for business. But if you use Facebook, you can upload, oh sorry, not Instagram, for example. You upload your, you snap a picture using your mobile phone, you upload it to Instagram, and somebody else with computer somewhere can see it. You can access your Instagram account using your mobile, tablet, or laptop, or desktop, or everywhere. Okay. A lot of companies use cloud computing. They don't have their own resources. For example, Netflix. Netflix use Amazon Web Service, Amazon Cloud Computing, for their system. So whenever you watch Netflix show, movie, series, then you use Amazon Web Service servers, Amazon Web Service storage, things like that. Another example for the cloud computing usage is the iCloud from Apple. Apple doesn't have their own servers. Apple use Google and Microsoft for their iCloud. So if you look at iCloud, behind iCloud, you will find Google and Microsoft. Okay. Open source software. Okay. Open source means free software, that's first. But it's not always only free. It's also including the source code. That's why it's called open source. The open source movement was started or founded by a person named Richard Stallman in the 70s, 80s. Richard Stallman was a programmer. And then at that time, he despised the practice of abusing license, I'll talk about license later, by a big company like Microsoft. Okay. Abuse means those companies use license as a way to get as much money from the customer as possible. Okay. So Stallman said, no, programmer should not sell their software. The software should be available freely and include the source code. So that's open source. Okay. So how Richard Stallman proposed for programmer to get money, not by selling their software, but selling services. Like if you want me to change the software for your computer, pay. If you want training, pay. If you want guidance, pay. If you want to use the software differently, pay. Okay, so that's with open source. There are plenty of open source license. Again, I'll talk about license later. But basically, open source software in different various different form of license They came down to few basics. First, it has to be free. Second, it has to include the source code. Third, user are free to modify the software. Okay. One of the most famous and the face of open source software is Linux. Okay. You can see Linux in many, many form. For example, Android. Android is the mobile version of Linux. You have Linux itself that can be installed in computers. Anybody use Samsung Watch? The operating system on Samsung Watch is called Tizen, and Tizen is a form of Linux. Any smart TV, usually Linux-based software. Okay. Why? Because it's free, and user can modify the software as they see please. However, not only that, user just cannot just use the software and modify it as they wish, but the modification will be open source also. That's why Android, when Google changed Android from Linux desktop laptop into mobile version, they make Android also open source. Okay, so technically you can download Android source code and modify it to run on iPad, for example. That's possible. Okay. In-house development. If your company have sufficient expertise, people, programmer, analyst, and so on, to build the system yourself, then it called in-house development. Okay. Now, when to use? Okay. If your need of software is generic need, similar to other people. Okay, it's common, nothing special. Buying is the best solution or using open source. Okay. Some companies, what they did was they buy a software, then ask the producer to modify the software according to their need. A lot of organizations use this. The US military, they can ask Microsoft to modify the Windows operating system for different purposes. Okay. In fact, 2 years ago, when Microsoft stopped the support for Windows XP, the US Navy paid few millions dollars to Microsoft to keep supporting Windows XP. Why? Because a lot of Windows XP, specialized version of Windows XP, was used in the US warship, okay, naval ships. So, and it's impossible for the US Navy to replace them at once. Okay, it will costly and it will create a chaos. Okay, so for the time being, they paid Microsoft for supporting Windows XP in the naval ships. Okay. However, if your need is very special, very peculiar, nobody else in the world have the same need as yours, then building or develop the software or system is the right choice. Why? Because nobody have the same requirements. It means that nobody sell the software. Okay, so you need to build. You can ask somebody else to build for you, or you can build yourself with the internal resources. Now, how to select off-the-shelf software or prepackaged software? Number one is the cost. Okay, comparing the cost of developing the same system in-house or with the cost of purchasing or licensing the software package. Now, with license, you need to be very careful because there are plenty of different license. There are perpetual license. It means that once you buy the software is yours, and you can use as long as you may. Please, okay, 10 years, 20 years, it's up to you. However, with perpetual cost, usually you don't get upgrade. Okay, so for example, if you buy a SPSS number version 25, for example, and it has perpetual license, you can use SPSS 25 as long as you like. But if there is XPSS 26, you can't. Okay, I have that one software. So this is a software, NVivo 10. I own this software. I own this software for almost 5 years now. The latest version is version 12, if I'm not mistaken. I can still use the software. However, it's not. I don't get the latest update, so I stuck with the software forever. Okay, so cost, licensing. There are licenses that had to be renewed every years or every few years, like for example, antivirus. Some antivirus will still provide, when you buy the license, they will provide you with complete package for protection, okay? But when you running out of the license, for example, next year, you're running out of a license, some software will provide basic function like antivirus. If you running out of the license, they still protect your system, they still update, but you lost some of the advanced features. Another software is SAS, for example. SAS is an advanced statistical package. It's used by Bappenas in Indonesia, for example, to analyze data, statistical data of Indonesian economics, for example. It was powerful software, okay, but SAS have peculiar license, your annual license, so you have to pay annually to SAS. Once the license expired and you don't renew the license, the software will not be able to be used. So when you try to run the software, it will just stop, yeah, because the license is expired. Okay, so you need to realize that. And licenses also have different types. In the early 2000s, late 90s, early 2000s, Microsoft were so eager to eradicate software piracy. Okay, so they working together with Indonesian authority. A lot of small internet cafe at that time being caught, not because they installed pirated version of Windows, no, they did have original Microsoft Windows. However, it was the wrong license. See, if you buy computers and Windows is included in that computers, you need to read the license. Usually the license is for personal use. So you can use that software for yourself, but not for commercial purposes like internet cafe. Internet cafe means that you rent the software. If you want to rent the software like internet cafe or computer rentals, then Microsoft have different license that cost differently, okay? And also you have to remember, that's why sometimes when you install software, make times to read the end user license agreement in completion, because sometimes the license is not transferable. So owning a software is not like owning a motorcycle. If you buy a motorcycle and you paid fully, then you can do whatever you like to that motorcycle. You can resell it, you can rent it, you can burn the motorcycles to the ground. But with software, it's not that easy. Some software allow transfer of ownership, some other don't. Some can be used in certain area, but not in other area. Okay. So you need to be careful about licensing. Second, you need to consider the functionality. Okay, the task that software can perform, and is it mandatory, essential, and desired? Okay. Is the software fulfill most of your need? If not, then take Microsoft Word for examples. Okay. If we look at Microsoft Word, where is it? Okay. All this functionality. How many percentage of this? How much percentage of this functionality usually you use? I suspect it's less than 50%, but you need still to pay full price for that. Okay. Vendor support, whether they have support or can they provide additional support, at what cost? Okay. The benefit of buying well-known software is the vendor support. For example, Microsoft. If you buy Microsoft product, they will support you. If they find any problem with the software, they will update the software. Okay, and you can get that update for free. There are plenty of training materials. They even have a training curriculum, and also they have a certification for that product, so complete package. But if you buy your software from a vendor across the street from your house, probably, they can support you. But when they went out of business, bad luck. Okay. Viability of vendor. Can the software adapt to changes in system software and hardware? Okay. Like what Microsoft did, what Google did. Okay. They update the system over and over. Okay. How easy it is to customize software, flexibility. The quality of documentation. If you buy from well-known software companies, then the documentation will be exceptional. You can find printing materials, you can find video tutorial, you can find step-by-step usage, things like that. You can even find case study. Okay, it's like some company using that software for certain purposes, and then you can see how they did it and learn from that. Response times, how long it takes the software to respond to user requests. Okay, so for example, how long it takes from you click the icon to the software being able to serve you. Okay, how easy to install. Most of Windows software are easy to install, but for server software, it's not so much. Okay, there are plenty of things that need to be set up before a software in servers can be used. Okay. The easier, the better. Okay, so how to validate software, purchase software. Collect as many information as possible. Okay. The benefit of using pre-purchase software or pre-packaged software is usually you are not the first. Okay, we are not the first. We can learn from somebody else. We can search the internet and find information on how other people's experience with that software. Okay. So, and of course, if we have difficulties, we can ask somebody else who also use the software. Okay, so we can learn from the other mistake. We don't need to experience the mistake ourselves. Okay, and like many other things, if you remember your accounting information system course, buying software is just like buying fixed asset. You go through tender process. So there will be request for proposal asking the potential vendor to submit their proposal for a tender, and then you will use that proposal to evaluate the product. Okay. I'll skip this because it's quite technical. Reuse basically means that you use whatever components that has been there. Okay, so that's it for our materials. Now, most of the time, the decision to buy or make will come down leaning to buying instead of making. Like I said, a lot of our needs in software or system, a generic need. So there's a good probability that out there in the marketplace, somebody already developed and sell the system. Okay, so by that, okay, instead of making ourselves, okay, people in Microsoft has been experienced in building software. People in IBM, people in Oracle, people in Google, Facebook, they have years and years of experience to build that kind of system or software or application. Okay, so we can tap into that expertise and pay a fraction of the cost for a good software. Okay. That if we need generic system. But if we need very specialized system, or we have system that need to be very secure, then probably developing ourselves is the best option. For a company, the best strategy is to have multiple sources. For example, company probably need operating system for their computers. Then for operating system is good option to buy, but which computer need that operating system? Most desktop and laptop will use either Windows or Macintosh OS, Mac OS, okay? Because it's convenient. However, on server side, they are different. Okay, Macintosh doesn't have server software. Windows, they have server software, but a lot of company doesn't really trust Windows for internet facing system. So that if you have e-commerce system, they don't trust Windows. But for internal purposes, usually Windows is sufficient. For e-commerce company, they will use open source Linux, for example. Okay, there are plenty of different Linux. Supercomputer. Top 500 supercomputer in the world using Linux. That's right. Okay, so different computers require different software with different sources. We already have Windows, Macintosh for desktop, and also Windows and Linux for server. If you look at Macintosh, they are specific kind of license. All Mac computers, MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, Mac Pro, iMac Pro, they actually, Apple doesn't sell Mac OS as like Microsoft sell Windows. Okay. You can buy Windows and install it everywhere you like, okay, as long as it's capable of. Windows have different version. But Macintosh, they only sell Mac OS. Apple only sell macOS with Apple hardware. So you cannot just buy macOS and install it on IBM laptop, for example. There's no IBM laptop. You cannot just buy macOS and install it on your Acer laptop or Asus laptop or Dell laptop or HP laptop. It's not working. Because Apple include the license of macOS with their hardware. And that's also applied to their product like iPhone and iPad. Android, different. You can download Android and install. That's why you can find Android in mobile phone, tablet, television, smartwatch, and kitchen appliances, and any other place. Because the open source license of Android allow that. Windows, you can install Windows in any computers. But you cannot modify it. So if you install the software in Dell computer, you cannot modify it. Okay, unless Microsoft provides written specific instruction. Some company also have. So if you look at this, Microsoft 365. If you use this, you cannot modify it. Some company provide modification. Okay. In the last my last consulting job with the e-procurement project, the Indonesian government got the software for e-catalog from a company in Europe. The e-catalog was used by European Union countries like Belgium, Scotland, Greece, and many other things. But it's not really suitable for Indonesia because Indonesia have different rules on e-catalog, so they have to modify it, and the company that sells that product modify the system. Okay. If you buy package software and you want to modify it, usually you have to pay for the producer to modify it for you. You cannot modify it yourself. Okay, it's prohibited in the license. It will be explained. Okay, that's it for our lecture today. You don't have to do mini assignments, okay? I'll consider you all, because it is that you all are here for these lectures and you already present your idea to me, so I'll consider it as mini assignment. Any question about our lectures today or the assignment?
No, sir.
Okay, good. So that's it for this week, and I'll leave you with the assignment. Remember which one is this? Okay. Work on it and justify. Forget to share the screen. So work on this. Okay, and submit it by before our next lecture. For next week, there will be no face-to-face lecture. There will be no video meeting. Okay, like I said, we are limited by university to have only maximum 7 online meeting like this. But I will leave you with some materials, and also you need to submit. I'll explain that in kuliah site next week, the description of your system. Okay, so describe your system completely next week. But next week there will be no video meeting, so you can just download the materials, learn the materials, and submit your system description later on as assignment. Okay, so that's it for today. See you next week, and keep healthy.